Hello students, feeling awesome to see you again. In my last video, we discussed about sound wave, terms related to sound wave, characteristics of sound, pitch, loudness, and timbre or quality. Let's begin with the next few topics to be discussed. Topics to be covered in today's video are audible and inaudible sounds, musical instruments, reflection of sound. Audible and inaudible sounds. Human beings can hear sounds of frequencies between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz are known as audible sounds. Sounds below 20 hertz and above 20,000 hertz cannot be detected by the human ear are called inaudible sounds. You heard about the term ultrasonic, supersonic, infrasonic sounds. The sound wave below 20 hertz of frequency is infrasonic sound. 20 to 20,000 hertz is audible sound, which can be heard by human. Above 20,000 hertz of frequency sound waves are known as ultrasonic sound. In our previous video, we discussed about sound produced by musical instruments, and it was known that whenever we talk about sound, the first thing which generally comes in our mind is musical instrument. Musical instruments are of varied types based on the design of the vibrating parts. Musical instruments can be classified into the following types. There are five types of musical instruments: aerophone or wind instruments. In wind instrument, sound is produced by a vibrating column of air. They have tubular structure and have holes along the sides of the tube. These instruments are played by blowing air through the mouthpiece. Chordophones are string instruments. In stringed instruments, sound is produced by vibrating or by plucking a string. These instruments are also consist of a hollow air chamber that help in increasing the loudness of the sound produced. Membranophones are drums, instruments which produce the sound of vibration of a tightly stretched membrane are called membranophones. Idiophones are percussion. Percussion instruments are the instruments that produce sound when it is struck, shaken, or scraped. In these instruments, the vibrating skin or membrane produces a musical sound. Electrophones, a device which produces sounds by electrical action or with the help of electronic components is called electrophones. Here you can see some examples for each one of them. Can you able to see that next slide? This is about reflection of sound. Similar to light, sound waves also bounce back from surfaces of objects. This bouncing back of sound waves from the surface of a solid or a liquid is called reflection of sound. For a proper reflection of sound, a smooth or rough surface is needed, and its size should also be large. The following are the two laws which govern reflection of sound. The direction of an incident sound wave and the reflected sound wave make equal angles with the perpendicular to the surface. The incident sound wave, the normal and reflected sound wave, all three lie in the same plane. There are a few applications of the reflection of sound are here. First, echo. If you visit an echo point of a hill station and shout loudly, you will hear the same sound after a little while. This sound is called an echo. Hearing aid. A hearing aid is a medical device which is used to improve the hearing ability of people who have difficulty in hearing. This device uses the reflection of sound to direct sound waves to a small area of the ear. Megaphone. It is a funnel-shaped device that is used for the amplification of the sound and its projection in a particular direction. This device works on the principle of reflection of sound. Stethoscope. Usually, such a device can be seen hanging around the neck of a doctor. It is used to hear sounds generated by internal body organs of human, like heartbeat. It also based on the principle of reflection of sound. Can you able to see the slide? It is showing the difference between noise and music. Noise is an unwanted sound that is usually very loud and meaningless. Music is the art of arranging and combining sounds in order to create harmonious melody. Noise has irregular wave form and wavelength and has low frequency, while music has frequencies and wavelengths that are harmonious. Noise can obstruct and confuse the spoken message of man and animals when they are communicating with each other. Music is pleasing to the ears, while noise is an unpleasant sound. Here you can able to see a slide which is showing noise pollution. Now, what is noise pollution? The most common and shortest meaning of the word noise is unwanted or excessive sound. Why it is unwanted or excessive? It is because of the loud, unpleasant, and destructive effect of noise. The adverse effect of noise caused by human on the environment is known as noise pollution. Few sources of noise pollution are mentioned below. Industrial sources, transportations, constructions, household, event and festival. So all together, they produce noise pollution. Here we have a slide which will tell you the methods to control noise pollution. Earphones should not be used for longer time. Use earplugs whenever exposed to high noise levels. Always choose residential areas far from heavy traffic prone zones. Always maintain a sound level in your bedroom of about 35 decibel at night and about 45 decibel during the day. If possible, avoid working in place where one is exposed to high level of noise pollution. So, can we quickly recap today's topic? Type of sound, audible and inaudible. Types of musical instruments, wind instruments, string instruments, percussions, electrophones, membranophones. Thank you and have a nice day.